Hello, planet Earth. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. We're at IDK, my BFF Jill730. I'm Personnel Young, wishing you warm salutations and congratulations as always. You've made your way to the Buffington Post. Today we're continuing my Season 8 coverage with Buffy the Vampire Slayer Season 8, Issue number 32. Oh my gosh, we are starting Twilight! It's the first issue of Twilight and it is called Buffy has fucking superpowers. Because, hey, Buffy has fucking superpowers! It's been a long road to get here, but we are finally hitting the hump. We are finally at this whole Twilight, what the fuck is it situation. Punchline is, Buffy went to go and bury her power, and after she did, she got superpowers all of a sudden. Took out goddesses, threw them around like they were friggin' nothing. So, let's just jump right into this. Here we go. It's the Buffington Post presentation of Buffy the Vampire Slayer Season 8, issue number 32, Buffy is fucking superpowers. Here we go.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Okay, so Buffy can fly around, she's super strong, and basically we pick up with Buffy and Xander, and they are testing the limits of her power. And basically, we find out that Buffy is in fact faster than a speeding bullet. Now, they're doing these funny, wacky tests with Buffy's new powers, and she can lift trains with one hand. And Dawn is just like, dude, this is not good. This whole situation is badness. Superpowers from nowhere, this isn't good. Like, Buffy is fucking superpowers, you know? And she's trying to get this across. But Xander and Buffy are just treating it like it's nothing. They're just really having fun being nerds about it, okay? So Dawn goes to Willow and she says, look, Willow, you should know better than anybody that you don't just get power for free. And Willow was saying, oh, well, maybe you're just jealous because you don't have powers. And Dawn says, no. Like, I don't need powers. And Willow says, well, maybe you're just a little bit jealous because Xander's spending all this time with Buffy. And she goes, no. It's not about Buffy. It's about Buffy's fucking superpowers. You don't just get something from nothing. Things have consequences. And she says, you know, the more powerful Buffy gets, you know, the bigger monsters we're gonna have to face. Like, so Willow is trying to figure out, like, why they haven't heard from Giles, Faith, or Andrew, because you would think that Andrew would be right there with Xander and Buffy doing all these nerd things. And so they're finally starting to put together that Giles, Faith, and Andrew aren't around, okay? And so back with Buffy and Xander, they are again testing the limits of her powers and what exactly she can do. And the fun thing about this is we all know that Buffy is pretty much modeled after Catherine Kitty Pryde or Shadowcat from the X-Men. We know she's modeled after Kitty Pryde, and it's because Kitty Pryde just, she's the honey badger. She don't give a fuck, you know? He says, can you phase? And she goes, what are you talking about? And he says, he explains to her what phasing is, and he says, and you're really cute, and you have this spunky personality, and you're not afraid of the tough guys who everyone else is afraid of. It's good stuff. And Buffy just goes, I don't see the appeal. Which is great, right? Like, Buffy, so smart. I love it. So we get to Willow, and she is trying to call out to Andrew, Faith, and Giles, like, figure out where they are. And then she's like, holy shit. So in the meantime, we pick up with Warren, Amy, and the general guy who are like wandering out in the wilderness, like outside of Camp Buffy. And so basically they are up to something. They're trying to like get into the camp for some reason or another. So Willow and Dawn rush out to Buffy and Dawn is like, I told you this was all bad. And they're like, shut the fuck up, Dawn. So, anyway, nobody wants to listen to Dawn. She's just Buffy's little sister. And Willow explains to Buffy that, hey, these guys aren't here. Like, Giles, Andrew, and Faith, I can't find them anywhere around here. Something's wrong. We need to go home, do some magic, and do the stuff. So, in the meantime, Amy, Warren, and the General have eluded being caught. So, Willow casts some crazy magic, and she's speaking in this crazy ancient language, but Buffy, because of her new fucking superpowers, can understand these words that Willow is saying, even though Buffy's, let's face it, not the brightest. So, yeah, these superpowers come with a lot of superpowers, apparently. So, basically, Willow is doing a spell to take her to the Slayer that needs her most. And Buffy goes, well, I thought I'm the Slayer that needs you most. And she goes, no, I'm looking for Faith, because face it, Buffy, you have friends. So she goes out looking for Faith. Amy senses that Willow has left, and she, Warren, and the General take this opportunity to do whatever they're up to. So Willow ends up in Kuala Lumpur, and she stumbles upon death. Okay, so all this good stuff. Willow goes from Malaysia to Miami to Louisiana, and she keeps just finding all of these slayers dead. And she finds out in Louisiana that they've been killed by mobs of people because, keep in mind, while everybody's all safe in Tibet, there are slayers out there in the world, and the human world has turned against them. And so they have literally slaughtered slayers all over the world while we've been in Tibet. So that's great to know. And this has all happened like over the past 2 days since they've fought the goddesses, right? So then we pick up with Giles, Andrew, and Faith, who of course had been kidnapped by Twilight. So they wake up, they're like, where the fuck are we? What the fuck? And then holy shit, they are in like this crazy villain HQ that has like this machine from, Andrew says from the X-Men Teen Titans crossover, and what is it? Darkseid had built this machine. Yeah, Darkseid had like built this machine to capture all the heroes and whatever, whatever. Yeah, he said it was part of our plan back in Sunnydale when we were gonna trap and kill you all. And so Buffy finds out that she has telescopic vision. She gets a little bit of funny stuff with this, but she sees that Warren, Amy, and the General are on the outskirts of their camp, and she goes and gets them real quick. So they apprehend them, and basically we find out that Amy, Warren, and the General had basically been duped. Twilight was using them the whole time, and they didn't appreciate that, and basically they want to ask Buffy if they can come play on her side, and if she'll let them play with them, they'll help her kick Twilight's ass. So she's like, okay. So then Willow comes back. She explains to Buffy, like, oh my gosh, these girls all over the world have been slaughtered. Like, they are dying. And your superpowers aren't coming as, like, some kind of universe reward for knocking out these goddesses. You're getting all of this power because all of these slayers all over the world, you're taking it from them when they die. And it's all building up in you and turning you into this super being. Buffy really doesn't like this, okay? And we'll explore that a little bit more in the next issue. And so, back in Twilight HQ, we've got Giles, Andrew, and Faith, who are trying to figure out, you know, what exactly is going on, why Twilight has them there, and all this good stuff. So, Andrew is just right at home. He knows how Warren thinks. He knows all the security codes and stuff like this. And yeah, he explains that, oh, well, clearly, Warren built a teleporting device that can teleport three people in and three people out of an area without any magical consequences. And clearly, Amy, Warren, and the General took their places. But wasn't there a fourth one, Faith says? And they're like, fourth what? And she says, well, Riley said that it was, you know, four bad guys. And then, hello, Twilight walks in and says, you can call me Twilight, actually. And who wants to hear a really cool master plan? So the next issue is The Master Plan. This issue was really fun. The fun with Xander and Buffy testing out her superpowers is just exactly on point. It made a lot of sense. I like that Buffy doesn't get a lot of Xander's nerd references. Dawn is used particularly well here. She's saying, monkey's paw, the whole time. And she's like, stuff doesn't just happen without consequence. And she's super right. Willow's used very well here. She basically goes and finds the terror of everything. And I like that she was smart enough to use a spell to look for Faith, and she was calling out to the Slayer that needed her most. Created a really interesting dynamic between her and Buffy for a split second, reminding Buffy that she has the most of all the Slayers. Not just these superpowers, but as far as like a support system. Giles, Andrew, and Faith. Andrew really got most of the talkie out of that, but it's fine. It really works for what's going on with them because we can't really get the hand tipped to us quite yet. And I almost showed you the trade paperback, but I don't want to spoil anything if you are holding on with bated breath. So, yeah, not a lot else to say. This is a good issue, and it's just gonna get crazier from here, you guys. So stay tuned. I'm Presnell Young. You can come right back here to the Buffington Post anytime for more season 8 coverage, Buffy the Vampire Slayer reviews, Angel and Faith reviews, Buffyverse discussions, discussions on the other Slayers. My opening themes and outros are in their own playlists over there. So check that out. I hope you're having a great 2015 so far, everybody. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.
You're beautiful, that's for sure. You'll never, ever fade. You're lovely, but it's not for sure. I won't ever change. And though my love is